John and Ken Show, John Cobalt and Ken Shampoo, KFI, AM 640, more stimulating talk radio.
All right, the voice line is 30 minutes away. It's breathtaking. It's captivating. People wait all week for it. That's a lot of hype. Part one, right after Shannon's news at 6 p.m., and then part two, right at the end of the hour to kick off your happy weekend. I'm happy, happy. Now you're not going to be happy when you hear this. We're pretty close. In fact, I believe this time it's going to happen. We're going to have a statewide plastic bag ban. Woohoo!
How nuts is this?
And will California become the first? Hawaii has one, but it's not statewide, but all four counties in Hawaii have a plastic bag ban. So technically Hawaii has it statewide. You see the difference?
Yeah.
It's a technicality, but California will be officially by voting statewide with the legislature.
So
let's explain first how it would work so people are clear. Starting in July 1st, 2015, you would have to pay at least 10 cents at grocery stores for what they call a reusable plastic or recycled paper bag from the grocery store. Single-use plastic bags would be prohibited under the bill.
All right, so you may be wondering why the grocery stores are going along with this, because clearly it's an irritating inconvenience for
customers. And in 2016, the prohibition would be extended to the pharmacies and the liquor stores. So it would start with the grocery stores.
All right, so here's why the grocery stores are in on it, and they are in on it, because the way the legislature is constructing this is the stores get to keep the 10 cents per paper bag they sell you. So now they've got a little income stream rolling here. All the paper bags that people buy, the money goes back to them, and they make a 3-cent profit on every bag.
This bill failed in the state Senate by just 3 votes. And what John is describing was one of the compromises reached by putting in the 10 cent per bag part. This freed up the grocers to say, sure. The grocery store company said, sure.
It's not a compromise. It's a bribe. What they did is the legislature is allowing.
Well, whatever they were doing to block the previous bills, that unblocked it. And now it has their support.
You know what? And I would be pissed off if I'm going to a grocery store and buying, let's say, $300 worth of groceries, and that's not enough. And then the grocery store chain made a deal with my idiot, corrupt legislator so that I have to pay a dime for every bag?
Yeah, it might only be a dollar. You get 10 bags. Ah.
That's a dollar. But that's a dollar every time I go. And that's a dollar, what, twice a week? 50 weeks a year? That's $100. It's a tax. It's a tax to carry the groceries to the car and then to my house. I'm getting taxed by the grocery store for buying their products? How crazy is that?
It could be, by the way, just to be clear on this, it could be a plastic bag they sell you. They're called reusable. You know how they define that? They have to be rated for 125 uses. I guess that means they can be used 125 times and they won't break or rip or fall apart.
Thicker plastic.
And made of at least 20% recycled plastic, but eventually that's going to have to be 40%.
And they've done studies. They did one in San Francisco. They looked at all the litter. Only one half of 1% of the litter was plastic bags. This is an overdone, hysterical, non-existent crisis. It's absurd. Most of the 99.5% of litter are not plastic bags. I'm just baffled by this. But you have environmental fanatics who are making campaign contributions to these characters. Now they're going to put 2,000 people out of work. They're going to destroy the plastic bag manufacturing companies that are based here in Los Angeles. For what?
Yeah, they claim it's a couple of thousand jobs. Well, the bill provides $2 million to retrain them to work in recycling.
That's a piddly amount of money. And
they're going to be trained to stand on those lines with and put the cans in the machine.
Government retraining programs are bogus, with a capital B-O. Bogus. It's just a cover story to make it look like they're business friendly. They're putting the plastic bag industry out of business because the environmental guys are paying more money in campaign contributions, and the grocery stores got this deal where they could keep the profit selling the paper bag. That's the unholy alliance.
Right.
All right? So you're getting screwed. You lose your freedom to use a plastic bag, which is really absurd, okay? You're more inconvenienced. Now you have to pay. Now there's 2,000 people who are going to lose their jobs because the issue was sold to the highest bidder. Because Democratic legislators are corrupt. Absolutely, positively corrupt. What changed between last year and this year when the bill failed? Nothing. Other than some of these guys maybe got a bigger check. Oh, I got a bigger check here. Oh, sure. Here's my vote. We need a cover story. Oh, $2 million in retraining money.
Yeah, that was the only real changes
they
made.
All right? So I went to the grocery store Sunday. It was a quickie trip, but somebody was coming over. I had to buy about $140 worth of stuff. And they said, do you want? And I make a point whenever the clerk says, would you like to purchase a paper bag? And I say, no, I'm never buying a paper bag.
Yeah, yeah.
Just put it in my basket. And me and my son, we rolled the basket to the car, and we hand-delivered the groceries from the basket into the car and then from the car into the house.
Takes longer, though, right? Because with a plastic bag, you can put like 10 cans and just lift the whole bag.
Yeah, but you know what?
How are you going to carry 10 cans?
The paper bags tear, especially at the handles. The handles,
they were good enough for us many years ago.
Well,
we only had paper bags years ago.
I know, but the way they have them now, the handles.
You're supposed to double bag.
Oh, yeah, I'm going to double bag and give them 20 cents each. And then you know what? If I start doing this, I start picking fights because if the guy wasn't putting enough in each bag to minimize the number of bags, I'd say, well, then you got to redo that now. You can do that in 6 bags instead of 8.
But if he puts it in 6 bags, they will rip. Be too heavy.
You see,
right?
That's right, because they're cheap and the handles are pasted on.
Oh.
And you pick up, because I've tried a few paper bags recently before they started charging you, and the handles come off like that.
What would happen if you brought your own plastic bags from home and you just handed them to the bagger there? Do you think they would comply?
Yeah.
No, I'm not talking about the reusable bags.
No, you can buy them online. You can buy, your own cheap, unrecyclable. But also, the idea that they're not recycled is nonsense because we have a whole bag of bags in the house that we use for all kinds of stuff.
You catch up, you use them all?
First of all, the ones we throw out go in the garbage. We don't throw them out into the wind. And then they're taken to the landfill, which is what landfills are for. And secondly, the ones that we don't throw out, we reuse over and over until they split up, and then we throw them out. I have not thrown a single bag into the wind in my life. So I'm getting a freedom taken away from me, and now I'm getting taxed. And people are going to lose their jobs over a phony issue.
It's killing ocean life. Bags are suffocating the dolphins.
No, it's morons, irresponsible morons, who don't throw the bag in the garbage. But again, 99.5% of litter in San Francisco were not plastic bags. It's a totally, it's just some activist group has an issue, and they want to use it for fundraising. So they'll make a wild claim. It's like, oh, my God, there's 5 billion bags in California blowing in the wind. Now, it's a lie. Nobody can prove or disprove anything, but it gets fundraising going because, you know, you get these people whose hearts start beating faster. They get surged with adrenaline. It's like, I got to donate money. I got to do something about it. They take that donated money, and they use it to bribe politicians with. It's just a shakedown scam.
If what we understand, it probably will cost the grocery stores anywhere from 7 to 8 cents for each of those bags they sell you for a dime. So
yeah,
that'll add up if they have hundreds of thousands of customers.
Well, instead of
buying them.
Now, what I've read is that grocery stores exist on a 1% profit margin, but for the bags, what? That's 3 extra cents of profit. That's actually 3 out of 7. That's a 40% profit margin.
So they don't want you to bring your own bags and bring your cloth bags. They want you to buy their bags.
Or you have to look like a silly fool, and you have to walk around as a grown man with like 15 canvas bags on your arm. Here's my recyclable bags, everybody. It's like, I'm not doing that. I have like some shred of dignity left.
Would you do that and then Instagram me a photo?
Well, yeah, that's what I'm going to do. Walk in with my canvas bags, which have all the E. coli and the salmonella at the bottom of it, because I didn't have time to put them all in the laundry.
All right, when we come back, oh, by the way, the toll-free number, 1-800-520-1534.